the board shall automatically become a member of the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects, end of quote, and shall receive benefits and privileges provided for this act after payment of the required fees and dues. It is on the basis of this provision of law that the commission and board issued a directive to enforce the compulsory membership in the IAPOA. In truth, all regulatory laws mandating an integration of the profession require mandatory membership in their respective IAPOs. Lastly, on the matter of the issuance of IAPOA Certificate of Good Standing vis-a-vis the payment of the annual IAPOA and chapter dues, a consultative dialogue was conducted on December 16, 2014 with the UAP and the PIA, where several options were proposed to address the matter on hand. The record of discussion is here, is also annexed in our submission, Honorable Senator. That's all, Mr. Senator.
Okay, thank you. So I presume the PRC architect Chua Chiaco has the same position?
Honorable Senator, it is the same position, except that if I may be allowed to add a few things. Okay. Just to say that the accreditation of the UAP as the integrated accredited professional organization was done after the passage of the law, and it went through a process which is applied to all the professional the regulatory board, the associations of the professional regulatory boards for the accreditation. So it is not only for the UAP. And that this was done way ahead of time. It may appear that we are both architects in the PRC now, but we were ordinary members of the UAP, if I don't know if PIA, LPA, during the integration. So we are not, we were not included, we were not instrumental to the accreditation. Thank you, sir.
Well, I would like to ask, do you have that power to appoint or to identify a specific professional organization as the accredited and integrated professional organization? I'm not just talking about the architects. Do you have that power?
Sir, it is not the power to appoint. It is the PRC has the mandate to accredit. It is not appointing.
It
goes through a process.
You accredit different professional organizations, but there's only one accredited integrated professional organization. And it applies to the other professions as well.
Yes, sir.
Do you have that power?
There is a criteria that is supposed to be submitted by the organization. If they pass that criteria, then they become the accredited and accredited professional organization.
Accredited professional organization.
Yes.
For example, in the profession of medicine, do you have that power, that mandate to anoint a specific accredited integrated professional organization? Can you show me the basis of that mandate?
Good afternoon, Honorable Senator.
Yeah.
Actually, sir, the selection or designation of the APO or IPO is open to all professional organizations, meaning any professional organization may file an application to become an APO or an IPO. Mm-hmm. But also, you were asking the basis of our power to accredit.
Yeah.
For example, in the architectural law, Section 40 of RA 9266 provides that integrated professional organization shall be accredited by the board subject to the approval of the commission. So that's the legal basis, sir.
Yes. But it speaks of a new organization altogether based on the law. It's generic, right? Is it? How do you interpret this provision? otherwise, the wording should have said, the board shall choose from among the accredited professional, existing accredited professional organizations. Right? It's not stated in the law that you have that mandate or that power to choose from among the existing. The UAP was created when 1975. So it was existing at the time of the promulgation of the law. So it's different from this one. At least that's how I looked at it, and that's how we've been looking at it. When we passed the different professional regulatory laws, we spoke of creation of an integrated professional organization that is not from among the existing professional organizations. Anyway, let's hold on to that. Let's hear from the PIA, architect call, please.
Good afternoon, Senator. Firstly, we would like to thank you for this opportunity so that we might clarify a lot of the issues involving our profession, a profession that we have loved for so long. If I may just read through our position paper, begging your indulgence, sir. The Philippine Institute of Architects holds that the implementing rules and regulations of Republic Act 9266 is not valid with respect to its provision on the process of integrating the architects into an integrated and accredited professional organization of architects, or the IAPOA. The accreditation of the United Architects of the Philippines as the IAPOA runs counter to the letter and spirit of Republic Act 9266. Only Congress of the Philippines as the legislative branch of the government is vested with the supreme legislative power or the power to enact laws, while Congress may delegate to administrative boards the authority to adopt and promulgate IRRs. It is always under economic standards and prescribed limits to guide those empowered to execute the law. The administrative body's sole duty is confined to implementing the law through the rules that it is bound to issue, hence the phrase implementing rules. The rules of regulations must therefore not support or be contrary to existing statutes. They cannot extend nor amend the law. They are valid only when they are not contrary to the law of the Constitution. The Supreme Court in Lokim versus Commonwealth laid down the requisites of administrative IRR to be valid as follows. Its promulgation must be authorized by the legislature. It must be within the scope of the authority given by the legislature. It must be promulgated in accordance with prescribed procedure, and it must be reasonable. Number three requisite is clear and unequivocal. It must be in accordance with the prescribed procedure. In the matter at hand, RA 9266 prescribes a procedure for the integration. Let us first quote the pertinent provision thereof, Section 40. Integration of the architecture profession. The architecture profession shall be integrated into one national organization which shall be accredited by the board, subject to the approval by the commission. As the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects, provided, however, that such an organization shall be registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission as a non-profit, non-stop corporation governed by its bylaws, providing for a democratic election of its officers. An architect duly registered with the board shall automatically become member of the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects and shall receive the benefits and privileges provided for in this Act upon payment of required fees and duties. Membership in the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects shall not be a bar to membership in other associations of architects. The post-COVID provisions lays down the integration process or procedure in the following order: integration into one national organization, accreditation by the board, approval by the commission of the accreditation, registration of the organization with SEC. In contrast to the following steps, which were taken pursuant to IRR adopted by the Professional Regulatory Board of Architecture, or PRBOA, towards the establishment of the IRBOA in the following order: organization of the UAP, petition by the UAP to be the IRBOA, registration of the UAP with SEC, accreditation of the UAP as the IRBOA, approval by the Commission. The procedure laid down by RA 9266 has obviously not been followed. The integration was preceded by the registration of an organization. The IRR issued by the PRBOA adopting and ratifying the erroneous accreditation of the UAP-IRBOA is contrary to law and must be rectified if not stricken down. Let us amplify further. RA 9266 clearly provides that the IRBOA shall be registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission. This means the IRBOA must be a new or fresh organization, not an existing one. The purpose of this requirement is obvious, so that all architects will be new members altogether in a newly established organization. The PRBOA missed the real legislative intent to establish a new organization of all architects. Had the law chosen an existing registered organization, it would have stated, provided further, that the IRBOA is registered with the FTC or the LAC. The word SAM denotes futurity. The word SAM, along with the word will, as words that are used to mark circumstance as occurring in future time. This construction is often referred to as the future tense of English. The application of the UAP as the IRBOA does not suit well with the meaning of integration as espoused in RA 9266, which prescribes the integration of the architect's profession into one national organization, as per Section 40, RA 9266. Integration means assimilation and coordination of all architects into one body or representation. The result of body or organization should be a new organization representing all architects in the Philippines. The IRR, however, simply handpicked the UAP, which was originally organized as a private organization of architects, such as the PIA, without considering the other existing private organizations, who have members of their own. In effect, the other private architects organization were disregarded as they were not given the opportunity to participate in the integration process. Stated differently, what happened was not an integration, but a prescription by the PRC and / PRBOA. For a compulsory membership in, if not subjugation, of all architects to the authority of a privately organized UAP. Indeed, this runs counter to the provisions of RA 9266. In fact, when the UAP petitioned the PRBOA to accredit it as the IRBOA, no public the rank of the other private architects organization under Section 1, Article 3 of the Philippine Constitution may have been violated. The IRR appointing the UAP as the arbora is inconsistent with the Equal Protection Clause under Section 1, Article 3 of the Philippine Constitution. Equal protection requires that all similarly situated should be treated alike, both as to rights conferred and responsibilities imposed. Similar subjects, in other words, should not be treated differently, so as to give undue favor to some and unjustly discriminate against others. In this case, the PR Bora unilateral and subjective selection of the UAP as the Arbora illustrates in an undue favor to the UAP to the discrimination of the other existing organization of architects. The PAA does not compete with the UAP, but it is time to assert that no rule or regulation, not even a law, should be used to grant undue benefit or recognition to a particular entity to utter disregard of other similarly situated entities. The unjustifiable accreditation of the UAP-Arbora has resulted to the UAP ridiculously attaining a dual personality. An Arbora on the other hand, or on one hand, and a privately organized UAP on the other. It discharges its functions as Arbora, but imposes upon its members additional duties or obligations in the manner by which other architects' organization would normally impose upon their members. A board partner, for example, is required to take oath to the Arbora, then take another oath to the UAP. As regards to the membership fees, the UAP collects Arbora fees, and at the same time, UAP chapter dues and other fees. Non-payment of all of these fees results in non-issuance of an Arbora certificate, which hinders the renewal of the architect's license. While we understand the sanction of non-payment of Arbora fees, we hold as unlawful the sanction of non-payment of chapter fees, as well as the requirement for payment of such fees. Section 40 of RA 9266 may prescribe payment of required fees and dues, but these fees and dues refer only to the Arbora membership fees and dues, and not to other UAP chapter dues imposed based on UAP's exclusive private capacity. For example, a member of the Philippine Institute of Architects will have to pay Arbora membership fees, UAP chapter fees, PIA fee, when he should only be paying Arbora membership fees and the PIA fees. The UAP chapter dues are no longer often connected with the Arbora membership fee. On the attendance of general membership meeting, the UAP penalizes those who are unable to attend with monetary fines, plus the reporting of their Arbora certificates. This is another imposition based on UAP's bylaws existing during the pre-Arbora period. The fact that they are still imposing it now proves that the UAP is functioning as a private organization equivalent to the other architects' organization apart from being Arbora. The UAP was by the IRR undue advantage over the other private architects' organization because the UAP can successfully impose its own set of fees apart from the Arbora fee upon all architects whose membership are mandatory, as compared to other organizations whose membership depend on the sole choice of the architects. At UAP, the architects have no option but to abide even though the UAP chapter fees and other obligations imposed by it have nothing to do with the Arbora membership. This is akin to putting on the UAP private organization a blanket of monopoly. Indeed, the UAP has been requiring architects to pay fees and dues, as well as obliging them to attend meetings and even sell raffle tickets upon threats of severe sanction of withholding of their IOPO certificates. These acts are consistent with monopolistic practices that must not be countenanced. Section 19, Article 12 of the Constitution provides that the state shall regulate or prohibit monopolies when the public interest so requires. The UAP maintains a general policy and operational structure which has been in effect even before its accreditation as IOPO. Today, the UAP has the same set of rules, same organizational structure, and same policy directions as the old UAP rules and policies, some of which are not in line with the traditions, orientation, sentiments, or institutional ideas of the Architects Organization, particularly the Philippine Institute of Architects. This is one concrete effect of the failure of genuinely integrate the architectural practice into one and new or national organization, representing all architects. This could result, as it may have already had, to discrimination and serious conflicts between original and non-original members of the UAP. The UAP may not be blamed in all these controversies under the presumption that merely acting based on a defective IRR. But it may not be allowed to assume dual personalities in one body. It must either be the IOPO or a private architects organization, but not both. Based on the foregoing discussion, the PRA strongly recommends to the Philippine Senate to instruct or recommend to the PR Board or the PRC to 1. Review and repeal Resolution Number 3, Series 2004. 2. To recall the accreditation of the UAP as the IOPO. 3. To conduct a genuine integration of all the professional aspects into a new organization to be accredited by it, which shall thereafter be registered with the OEC. And 4. Enjoin all architects' organizations to agree among themselves to support the new integration and accreditation of the IOPO. Thank you, Mr. Senator.
Thank you very much, Architect Colcol. Before moving forward, let me acknowledge first the presence of Senator Bongbong Marcos. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Let's now get the response from the UAP, United Architects of the Philippines. Ma'am, please.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Mr. Chair, Honorable Senator Terianes. Thank you for inviting the United Architects of the Philippines in this hearing. The United Architects of the Philippines was granted the Certificate Number 1, the first professional organization accredited by the PRC on May 12, 1975. After the passage of RA 9266, or the Architecture Act of 2004, the legal selection of the UAP as the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects was carried out via the application of the UAP to the PRC with corresponding letters of support dated May 12, 2014 from the following organizations: the Philippine Institute of Architects, duly signed by the President, Architect Orlando C. Villarin, and other officers; the Architecture Advocacy International Foundation, duly signed by the President, Architect Greg Timbor, the second, and other officers; and the Council of Consulting Architects and Planners of the Philippines, duly signed by then-President Architect Geronimo V. Manahan and other officers. Thereafter, the PRC, through the Professional Regulatory Board of Architecture, accredited the UAP as the IOPOA. Certainly, from the past the present, the UAP is joint. The UN has enjoyed the unanimous support of all the architectural organizations. Moreover, even in the present, the UAP has received, last December 17, 2014, a letter of support from the Philippine Institute of Architects, Makati-based, signed by the PIA President, Architect Maria Cynthia Naval, and the National Secretary. As Ayapua, the UAP has received many awards, including the highly acclaimed PRC's Most Outstanding Accredited Professional Organization. To date, it is the first and only APO to win the award 5 times in the award's 18-year history, years 2002, 2007, 2008, 2011, and more recently in 2014. The award is presented annually to recognize the achievements, services, and commitments of the APO to the profession. UAP has bested 42 other professional organizations through 12 stringent criteria set for the award. The record of the UAP as a leading APO shows a high level of institutional professionalism and excellence. Hence, there can be no doubt that UAP has upheld its mandate as the Ayapoa. The Ayapoa has acted for and in behalf of all the Filipino architects with their best interests at heart and in an inclusive and integrative manner. The track record of the UAP shows this. Majority representation of architects in the UAP. To date, Your Honor, we have 11,776 members in good standing, spread all over 136 chapters, 18 of which are abroad. And if I may add, Your Honor, that it is not during the meeting with the PRC last December 17, we encouraged the PIA to submit to us all the list of all the violations that they have and to document them so that we can specifically address all these concerns and problems within our own ranks. Because if they say that there are chapters who are violating and not allowing other members of the PIA to be registered or to be to join or not to join the events of the UAP and penalizes them, then perhaps we told them that please submit to us so that we can properly address them. Also, Your Honor, we would like to inform you that the UAP has also given we have also encouraged the participation of the PIA and the AAIF in the crafting of our legislative agenda for the strengthening of our law. We have consulted them in several avenues, in several meetings, wherein we consulted them in the crafting of the architect's guidelines, which we have submitted to the PRC Board of Architecture prior to their approval. And also, we have also invited them to, we have given them copies of the draft amendments to the RA 9266 in order that we may get the cross-section of all the architectural associations and not only of UAP. That is why, Your Honor, we were able to submit to Congress our draft amendment to RA 9266 being sponsored by Congressman Susan Yap, and this has already passed on the first at the committee level. I am very glad, Your Honor, that we have been able to do this together with the UAP and some inputs from the AAIF and from the PIA. And it saddens me that this hearing should come at a time when we needed the unification and the cooperation of all architects in the country. Because, you know, Your Honor, we have been preparing for the ASEAN integration, and we want to have a common stand when ASEAN 2015 finally comes in or finally takes effect. In the light of globalization, we are also pursuing some specialty councils wherein our members will be given the chance to be able to bring to the fore their expertise on several fields. And we are in the process of putting up these specialty councils. We are also, Your Honor, doing some Bayanihan Arkitektura a corporate social responsibility program of the UAP, and we have been, our chapters nationwide have been doing projects along this program. So, Your Honor, I believe that the architects must really unite, and I am one in saying this with the AAIF and the PIA, both Makati and Pasig based chapters or associations, to please let's all move forward and let us we have ASEAN 2015 to face the globalization that we are all afraid of. We must all equip ourselves so that we will be able to transcend and even ride the tide of change that is about to happen in our country. Thank you, Your Honor, and I would like to say again that thank you for the opportunity to give it to the UAP on behalf of the 12,000 strong UAP members. I would like to thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you, Architect Rigala. Can I hear from the chairman of the PRB?
Good afternoon. Senator Trillanes. Good afternoon, my fellow architects from UAP, PIA, Makati, and of course our co-workers in the government. May I be allowed to read my position, sir? The integration of all architectural profession organization, the Philippine Institute of Architects, the League of Philippine Architects, and the Association of the Philippine Government Architects, APGA, took place and integrated it into architectural profession organization and called it the United Architects of the Philippines. That was the born of United Architects of the Philippines. The United Architects of the Philippines, the architectural organization registered in the Security and Exchange Commission, having the biggest membership, is the existing professional organization of architects during the passage of the RA 9266, otherwise known as the Architecture Act of 2004, and the first professional organization in the Philippines recognized by the Philippine Professional Regulation Commission, PRC, having the registration number 1. The application of the United Architects of the Philippines as the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects, or IAPOA, was supported by the Philippine Institute of Architects when they are only one PIA then, and the Architecture Advocacy Institute, International Foundation, and the Council of Consulting Architects and Planners of the Philippines. Letter of support attached herewith. Therefore, by virtue of the support given by the three organizations of architects, namely the Philippine Institute of Architects, the Architects Advocacy International Incorporated, and the Council of Consulting Architects and Planners of the Philippines, and submission of all requirements, the Professional Regulatory Board of Architects, through the Professional Regulation Commission issued the PRC-PRBOA Resolution Number 3, Series of 2004, recognizing the United Architects of the Philippines as the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects. In my statement, sir, I have attached document that supported this statement. May I be allowed to submit this to you, Your Honor?
Please, Architect Cordero, please submit it to the committee.
Yes, I am submitting this, sir, to prove that my predecessor in the PRBOA has not missed the law of, their duty to recognize the accredited organization.
Thank you. Let me now hear from the architect. Architectural Advocacy International Foundation, please.
Good afternoon, Senator, and as with the others, we thank you all of us thank you for the opportunity to discuss this matter. This has been a long time coming, but nonetheless, we are very, very thankful that finally the Congress of the Philippines, particularly the Senate, has been or is able to look at this matter. I shall not be reading my position or the position of the AIF. It is there for all to see, and the position is articulated, well articulated in that paper. But let me summarize it a bit. The AAIF position essentially is that the law, especially Section 40 of RA 9266, mandated a prospective integration of the architecture profession. When we talk about the architecture profession, we do not only talk about juridical entities. We don't only talk about natural persons. We talk about a lot more than just natural or juridical persons, and we're hoping that in the future editions of the IAPOBA, all of the other players in the architectural profession and the industry would all be given a voice in the management of the affairs of the architecture profession. The 2004 endorsement by the AAIF, of which I was an officer at that time, and of the CCAP, of which I was also an officer at that time, is basically premised on the full satisfaction of the integration of the architecture profession. The recognition extended by the board or the accreditation extended by the board is not the same as the integration of the profession. It is a mere act of the board and an acclamation by the architectural associations at that time, so that there could be a means of operationalizing the concept of the IAPOA. We could not leave that position of IAPOA vacant, and so something had to be done, and that was what the associations did. But that did not mean that they were giving up the concept of integration. We were all looking forward to the concept or to the realization of that integration of the profession. There was mention about two speakers earlier mentioned about the UAP being pre-existing. That is also the position of the AIF. The IAPOA is an entity, a juridical entity created by law. It does not refer to a pre-existing private association. And lastly, the IAPOA was mandated to make all registered architects, there are 35,000 of them right now, its members. The IAPOA could not select or was not allowed by the law to select or to choose its members. Right now, the only members of the IAPOA are the registered and licensed architects. There are about 11,700, as mentioned earlier by the president of the UAP, leaving out in the cold something like 23,000 registered architects. No. The law is very clear that all the 35,000 registered architects should be IAPOA members. And the law also did not say that the IAPOA can prevent these RAs who are desirous of becoming IAPOA members from becoming such. Basically, that is what I could summarize. But again, the position of the AIF is articulated in our paper dated 19 January. And before I conclude, let me just beg your leave, because I may have to go around 3 o'clock to take a flight to Mindanao. Thank you very much again, Mr. Senator.
Thank you very much, Architect. So I think we've heard the major organizations and the PRC and the PRB. Okay, here's my take. I go back to the basis of the accreditation by the PRB, right? Which is Section 40. And this is exactly the template that we're using in the different professional regulatory laws that we're making right now. And it's how it's the same way that I interpreted this section, this similar provision, which is it's not to be chosen, it's not to be chosen from existing, because it will defeat the purpose. You cannot integrate everybody because they are already segregated through these different professional organizations. And this particular sentence, was this membership in the integrated and accredited professional organization of architects shall not be a bar to membership in other association of architects. I think it's very clear. UAP is association of architects, so it cannot be the mother professional organization. Now, we need to rectify this. This is the same problem as I mentioned to you yesterday, that we have with the other professions, and the formula or the template that I'm thinking of is the creation of this new body and the members or the number of representatives in a particular board would be equated or commensurate to the number or the percentage of the membership of that particular professional organization. For example, if UAP comprise 90% of the membership of the architects, then you get 90% of the seats of the board of that IAPOA. So that way, there won't be any monopoly, and it's equitable. UAP will get the lion's share because you have the lion's share of the members right now. But it will also encourage a free market of ideas through this arrangement, so that organizations like AAIF and the PIA can also provide new perspectives, new ideas from their own organizations. Strictly speaking, whoever did this, whoever accredited the UAP, violated the law, and I can file a case right now to whoever did that, and who would continuously do countenance this blatant violation. It is not the intention of the law. I should know, because we have passed 6 similar laws covering different professions, and that's how I understood it. It's the same thing, and I'll read to you section 30 of the recently passed chemistry law. The chemistry profession shall be integrated into one national professional organization of chemists that is duly registered with the SEC. The board shall be subject to approval by the commission, shall accredit the organization as the one and only integrated and accredited professional organization of registered chemists and chemical technicians. All chemical technicians and chemists whose names appear in the registry book of chemists shall ipso facto be automatically members thereof and shall receive the benefits and privileges pertinent thereto upon payment of membership fees and dues. Membership in the integrated accredited professional organization shall not be a bar to membership in the other chemistry organizations. So it's the same thing. So we're the ones making this law, so we know the intention and the spirit of this particular provision. And now I'm telling it to the PRC and the PRB of architecture that's not how it should be interpreted. So we will have to remedy this this situation, and again, the UAP should not be worried about losing any influence, precisely because you have the bulk of the membership. But moving forward, that's how it should go. Everybody should compete. So you will have to come up with fresh ideas and come up with more convincing marketing techniques to get new architects to your fold, thereby ensuring your seat in that board. That will be the main voice, the only voice of the architecture profession. Now, I agree with Architect Regala's call for unity in face of the ASEAN integration, and you didn't mention the move of the civil engineers to include in their own professional regulatory law that authority and right to sign architectural plans. I think it's something you should be more worried about. So I think that is how we should move forward, Commissioner Reyes, Commissioner Chua, and Architect Cordero. The law is being violated as it is. I should know, because we've been very, very careful in moving forward in the other professions. Because if we allow this thing to happen in our architecture, once we get to pass the PRL for medicine, you will also have that power to anoint and accredit any of the existing accredited professional organizations, and you will start another front in that regard. Maduguyon. Ganun din sa ibang mga professions. So, may formula. Would you be amenable to that proposal? You sit down, you form this new integrated professional organization of architecture based on the law, on the spirit of the law. Yung representation niya is based on the existing number of or percentage of membership. So, for the existing professional organizations, if you only represent so many percent, then you only get a corresponding seat. So there'll be re-election, let's say, for every 3 years. So again, titignan doon kung ilan yung membership nyo. Kung eventually na-dissolve yung organization ng isa, then they don't get any seat. But you can now have the two entities na sinasabi. Kasi maliwanag dito. And just for clarity, tatanungin ko lang, totoo ba ito na dalawang oath ang tinitake nila? Is that true? One for Ayapoa? Yes. One for Ayapoa and one for UAP?
No. Only one for UAP. Only.
One for UAP?
UAP as the Ayapoa po.
As the...
They only take their oath as UAP members.
Oh. Yung statement niya dito na they take oath as a member of the Ayapoa and the UAP. So...
If I may, yeah. Senator. Okay. In the context... of their interpretation of because of an IRR that UAP is appointed as Ayapoa, ergo UAP is the Ayapoa, but we still believe that they are two separate entities. But ever since, even during when I graduated, that has been practiced. That when you come into oath-taking, when you take your oath as a registered professional in the profession, the UAP was there. And it should not be a practice that we should be condoning, simply because you cannot have a private organization inside an oath-taking that's for the government.
Okay, anyway, itong, what's this, if you don't get, what's this, the UAP certificate, hindi ka makakapag-practice ng profession mo? Ayapowa. So, ganun ba yun? Does that, is that equivalent to a board exam? Nakapasa ka na ng board, tapos you cannot practice a profession? That's not the intention of the law. So,
may I answer that,
yes,
sir?
Yes.
The Board of Architecture, through Board Resolution Number 2, issued a resolution that the architect to registered must pay the annual dues and to be given the certificate of good standing. And also a legal opinion was sought by the PRC regarding the board resolution requiring payment to the association. That is all, sir. To renew the PRC, to renew the PRC identification card.
Okay. Pero kung hindi pa pwede yun, ha? Wala dapat magiging bar once you get to pass the board exam at nabigyan na kayo ng license ng PRC, you should be able to practice. Wala dapat bar yun. Is that on record?
Sir, there is no mention that hindi pwede mag-practice, but hindi pwede mag-renew ng ID. Yan po yung nakalagay sa board resolution number 2.
Hindi makakapag-renew ng
PRC card.
PRC card,
yes,
yung license. Kapag hindi sila nakapagbayad dun
sa membership dues.
Membership of?
Membership dues of the association or the IAPO.
IAPO. Kaso nga, technically, wala pa tayong IAPOA. Ako sinasabi ko sa inyo, what you did was a violation of the law. I can ask my lawyers to file the corresponding case, administrative case to the ombudsman sa PRC and PRB for continuously condoning that. But sabi ko nga, hindi natin gagawin yon kasi meron tayong formula. They need to get their acts together. You need to step back and let them sort this thing out in accordance with the law. If this provision will not be implemented, hindi pwede ikutan ito. Hindi pwede.
May I add another thing, sir? The PRBOA, through my leadership, in the past 2 years, has called PIA Pasig and PIA Makati to a meeting regarding the difficulty in paying the annual dues. So they are here to attest that I have called this meeting and tried to make some ways that so that the UAP can accept the payment of the membership dues.
Well, understand that, architect, but that's a separate issue altogether. I may understand you for interpreting the law the way architect Bautista interpreted it a while ago, but I am telling it to you now that it's a violation. Kami yung gumagawa ng batas dito kasi ganyan din yung nagiging problema namin, eh. Maraming mga nakaugat na apo sa iba't ibang profession. And if you give that power to PRC, what if theoretically you give it to the apo, pre-existing apo na ang membership lang niya would represent, let's say, 2% ng kunyari chemist. Kasi arbitrary, eh. Right? Arbitrary. So, theoretically, imagine, the 98%, ano nga gawin nun? Huh? So, no. Ang sinasabi ko rito, architect, Chua, it's not in the law. We didn't give you that power to choose. Did we give you that power to choose? Okay, sige. Lahat naman tayo, may background sa basic English. Tignan natin dito, where in Section 40 was that power given to PRC? That there is a criteria to choose. Walang selection process dito. It is about a new organization. And it's very dangerous. Sabi ko nga, I can't give you that, I can't even allow it to happen kasi it's going to be a precedent setting to be used by the other professions. We're trying to avoid na magkagulo-gulo sila. Kaya nga, we're very, very careful in moving forward. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Senator, Honorable Senator. Just looking back po, during the time of the passage of the law, it shows in the history that the associations existing at that time agreed that it's going to be UAP who will apply because it's by application.
Okay. I agree. It was mentioned earlier about the technical waiver. But continue. Kahit mag-agree kayo dyan, kung wala yan sa batas, it cannot be done.
Apo. Kaya lang po, that's why that's why UAP continued to exist as the IAPOA or the Integrated and Accredited Association of Architects. That's why PRC also recognized it as the one representing officially the architects. But I think also I hearing the paper or the position paper of Architect Kolkol, it seems that he was misinformed about so many things about UAP. And one thing is the taking oath twice to the IAPOA and UAP. In the oath taking, you will take oath twice. One, as an architect, being an architect, recognized architect in the government. And the other one is to the IAPOA or to the UAP. So, yun lang pong dalawang yon. So, there is no oath taking to IAPOA and oath taking to UAP. Mm-hmm. So, it's a misinformation. And other things that, you know, because he used some strong words like raffle tickets and all that.
Well, hindi ko naman sinama na.
Opo. But we would like to add further din po that being as UAP members also, UAP did a lot for the profession, both in the national front and the international front. So, yun lang po, we just want to add that.
Yes, ma'am.
We just want to put that on record as well.
Yes, and nirecognize natin yan. And we're not taking away anything from UAP. Kaya nga sila may pinakamalaking membership, right? Probably because marami silang ginawa. At hindi natin mawala, even in the formation of this new organization, they should get the bulk precisely because their membership represents the bulk of the total architects. So, pero yun lang. We need to be consistent with this provision. And yun, ma'am. At mabilis lang ito. If you really want to, then you can move forward. Doon lang naman yun eh. Kayo rin ang uupo doon. Kayo rin. It's the same thing. But from here on, you'll be moving forward together. Nawala nang dissenting voice kasi everybody's represented. Pero represented equitably and commensurate to their total membership. So, ganun ang magagawing template namin even sa ibang professions kasi parang corporate structure. Diba? If I own 50%, I get 50% of the board seats, etc., etc. So ngayon, maganda yan as a policy making body. So, ma'am?
I would just like to add, sir, that the UAP has always been open
to the suggestions and recommendations of all organizations. As a matter of fact, we have already been inviting them since the start of discussions about certain documents that are the instruments of our practice. So they have been participants in such dialogues. And I have always encouraged them to please come to our office should they have issues with us, because we do not want that we wash our dirty linen in public. We want to be united. As it says, it's a United Architects of the Philippines. So it is really in the best interest of the Filipino architect that we are opening our office and our doors to all those who have recommendations and suggestions for the benefit of the profession. And may I clarify, sir, that the UAP dues that they are paying are association dues. And we are not charging extra dues being the AYAPOA. Our members in good standing are the ones shouldering our expenses in the lobbying for reforms and for changes and international representations. These are the operational costs that UAP are incurring. And our members in good standing are the ones shouldering these expenses. We do not ask other associations to share in whatever that we have, in whatever actions that we do for the profession. Our members are the ones solely incurring these expenses for the profession. So that's only I just want to clarify that, Your Honor.
Yes, ma'am. And I commend the UAP under your leadership for that, which is precisely nakikita ko rito mas doable, mas workable than yung sa medicine and the pharmacies and the other professions. So, kaya nyo mag-usap-usap dito. At kayo pa rin ang hawak niyan. Ganun eh. It's how it should be crafted. Equitable membership eh. Hindi naman, I don't think you demand na you get 50%. No. Hindi pa pwede rin. So, ganun lang yan. Then, it can be the template for the different professions as well. Kasi, kung magagawa niyo yon, yun na, lahat na ngayon. Kasi kayo pa rin na mag-aano nun eh. Yes, ma'am?
Sir, I just want to know, because since this will be a template and there are some oversight committees or some oversight boards also under me that have the same situation, so yeah. I would like to be guided if this template will be an association of associations or yeah. Association of juridical or of natural persons.
No. This will be association based on the law of the number of professions, of all the professionals, you know, in this case, architects. So, natural persons. Then, if you're going to set up a corporate type entity, then I think that's the best formula. You take the total number of architects, divided by the total number of members per professional organization, then divided by the total members, let's say 80%, then get 80% of the seats, etc., etc. Then they can now collect dues as members of the AYAPOA. You take away part of that for admin expense, then the rest of it, they can pour it back to the profession or whatever, kung ano nang makuha nila. Pero at least you'll just be dealing with that united body. Wala nang dissenting voice. Dahil yun na eh, that's the setup na eh. Ngayon kasi talagang, alam nyo, next step dito, somebody will file case, somebody will, alam nyo, wala yun. Everybody loses in that situation. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, who will organize this new organization?
Kayo.
PRC?
Kayo.
Who will be leading?
Lahat kayo. Everybody will be consulted. The PRC will, syempre kayo stakeholders, kayo yung ando doon, and your interest will be protected. All of the interests will be protected. The interest of the majority as well as the minority. So, kayo yan. Every step of the way, once everybody's in agreement, move forward. Ano nyo na, i-file nyo na sa, mabilis ito. Then, ano na yan? Yes, architect.
Regarding your template, do you have any timeline for that? Or because are we assuming now that UAP is the exist as IAPOA now, and then we have to organize a new integrated based on the template that you were suggesting?
Let's just say that may transition period. Kasi as it is, the law is being violated. Ang problema kasi nito kasi may pera eh. Di ba? If somebody would come in, sige, mag-audit ang COA o mag-file ng Supreme Court o kung ano-ano, it will be bloody eh. So, gawin na lang natin. Gawin itong ano na ito. Let's unite all the fronts. Ha? Kayo, PRC ang nasa forefront ito. You will rectify the situation and everybody will put in their inputs to make sure na walang mga agrabyado dito. So, pero after that, wala na yan. Wala na tayong reason na maging ano pa rin, dissenting voice kasi isa na tayo. Yes?
Sir, if I may, who will fund all these things that are going to the new organization? And ano, syempre, may...
Ano ba yung magpa-file lang ng
may, SEC? But sir, organizing and having all this paperwork and all the hours and bunuhan time and ano?
Oh, bunuhan na ron ng PRC. Again, oh, mabilis yan. That would be the list of your worries. Yes, so that would be the list of your worries right now. Ako, I'm just trying to, in fact, pag naging, ano ito, na i-launch nyo po ito, na yung na-unite lahat ng IAPOA, then magagawa na natin lahat yan sa lahat ng professions. Yes, ma'am. Wala na ngayon.
Sir,
yes.
Since we believe that the PRC and the PRBO will supervise this, yeah, reorganization or organization, maybe request these organizations, the three
UAP,
PIAs.
Hindi, dapat isa lang ang bosses.
That is what we are telling them.
Isa lang. Kumbaga, say nyo yan. Dapat, ayusin nyo yan. Oo, kumbaga, yung total membership nyo yan, it will be added, pero you would only have one voice. Ngayon, if you have if you're entitled to 2 seats, that won't be a problem, but as I see, the bulk of the seats would go to UAP, so sila pa rin na mag-provide na ano. Pero ang pinakang challenge dun sa ibang organizations, ano pa rin kayo, magsusumika pa rin kayo na maging maganda yung organization nyo para maging attractive doon sa new architects to join nyo. Diba?
Sir,
thank you again, Senator Trillanes. Probably a brief comment on the prorating formula. The thing I see about the prorating right now is that it cannot be equitably applied because UAP had 11 years of build-up.
Ganito na lang yan. Ma'am, ilan ang accredited professional organization ng architects?
Yung accredited, sir, isa pa lang. Yung pong...
Hindi, yun yung... IAPO, integrated accredited.
Yes, sir.
We're talking about APOS.
APO means A, means accredited. Okay. Pero... is the professional
organization.
Professional organization is 2.
Hindi, ayun kasing inaccredit nyo because of this new law. But before, yan yung interpretation nyo eh. Ang, prior to that, mayroong iba't ibang professional organizations recognized ng ano. So, sino-sino yun? Ito.
So, yung po kasing UAP was made up of the 3 organizations. Okay. So, yung PIA, LPA, ADPA. So, yung LPA and ADPA do not exist anymore.
Okay. So, ngayon, nakikita ko, UAP-PIA, AAIF. Pero yung PIA, ayusin niyo yung problema niyo. Hindi, bahala na sila doon. Okay? Pero this thing will move forward kung hindi niyo, if you don't get your acts together, mapag-iiwanan kayo rito. So, you just need to talk to three. So, magpapatawag yung PRB at the PRC, you should be there. Pag hindi kayo pumunta ron, it means a waiver of your rights and interests. Attorney, yes.
If I may, Senator. At the moment, because of what has happened, let me just go back just a little bit. Because of what happened, some of us, or a good number of us, have dual membership because of these provisions that... so does that mean what? That we can resign our membership from the UAP and just do a single okay. Because that will be a count against us again
those are details that I think should be fleshed out in your subsequent meetings with the PRC, but as it is, you'll have to recognize and appreciate the gesture of the UAP that they're willing to bend backwards here for the sake of unity of everyone. So, kumaga, take your gains for the moment and be happy with it. Then, let's trust the leadership of the PRC and the PRBOA na para ma-resolve din ito. Kaya nga, you should be there. And ako naman, andito din ako. So, kung anong kailangan natin ayusin natin. Tapos, para matulak nyo na rin yung PRL ninyo to face precisely yung ASEAN integration and the others. Yes.
Just one last comment before I go, Senator. You did mention earlier on about the requirement for the renewal of the license, mm-hmm. and there was mentioned that this is in violation of law. Mm-hmm. So is there also an instruction to the Board of Architecture and the PRC to revoke the resolution requiring the presentation of an IAPO certificate prior to license renewal?
Okay. Let's just say everybody's in the transition period. Okay? We will not mess up with that system for now. Kaya paspasan natin ito. I believe 3 months would be a fair time to get this new organization going. That will cure that particular dilemma. So,
in fairness, sir, pag ang PRBOA nagpatawag ng meeting, dumarating po yung PIA, dalawang PIA and UAP.
Okay. So,
in fairness, sir.
So, just be there pag nagpatawag ko yung ano. May transition period na lang muna tayo dito. The sooner we get this thing going, di ano na tayo rito. The next time na magkikita tayo would be pag tinutulak na natin yung PRL ninyo.
Sir, can we do first the unification of PIA? Para po isa lang po ang kausap namin.
Yes, ano yan?
Alam mo yung problema ng PIA, madali na namin ma-resolve yan eh. But that should not be a hindrance to the purpose of the senator that we pursue the template that he wants us to do. Like, for example, with regards to the problem of money, right now, ang iapuwa, ang daming pera eh. Gagamitin muna natin na pag ginagawa natin itong sinasuggest ng senator.
No.
Diba?
Architect.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Ano yan? Hindi. Wala yan. Kumbaga, there won't be any accusations about mishandling of funds. It was never brought on the table. Let us give the benefit of the doubt to the present transition IAPOA. So, kwan muna tayo. Let's hold on to our horses. So, dito muna po tayo sa unification ng kwan. Ng buong using that template, ma'am? Yes?
So, yung template po na sinasabi nyo, what form will that come in? Ma'am, what is the template?
Ma'am,
because when you say template, that means it's something that will be applied to all the professional regulatory boards, the professions. Yes. So is it something that we will draw on our own or come from you?
Ma'am, sa inyo na po ito. Kasi eventually you will be dealing with all these problems eh. So, kumbaga, you'll be coming in the coming up with this IAPOA with the mindset that this is a template for the other professions as well. Para ganun, ma'am, yung template. Mas maganda. Kayo na, ma'am. Yes. Kung kayo na model. Kasi magulo pagka nakita natin, if it worked for the architects, it should work for everybody. Ganun po ang ano na lang, mindset, ma'am. So, okay po, para ma-ano na rin natin ibang na nahihirapan ako eh. So, ma'am, okay? Oh, sige, architect.
Just for the record, there's a fourth organization. It is called the Architecture Advocacy Federation. It was registered with the SEC in early 2014. They are here right now. The president and the secretary general are here.
Ano yan?
It is an organization of architects, registered architects, and architectural organizations and firms.
Ano yan, ma'am? Anong masasabi niya dun?
If that would be an association of associations, but he's talking, the good senator is talking about natural persons.
Natural persons. So, no, we're talking about natural persons. Kasi for the purposes of distribution later on, we can't. It will be difficult. So, let's simplify the problem muna. So, ma'am?
Oh. So, I believe that association can exist, but not in the context of the IAPOA.
Okay. So, yun. I think, okay kami. Then, kung may problema ho tayo, then, pag-usapan natin ulit. Okay? So, with that, this committee hearing is hereby adjourned. Thank you.